Hello and welcome to NewsClick. Today we have with us Sri T.N.R. Rao, former Petroleum Secretary and who's been associated with the oil and petroleum sector for a long time. Paranjoy Guha Thakurta, who's also been associated with the oil and gas sector in terms of writing a couple of books on it and various exposes and articles on it. Today we're not discussing the oil and petroleum sector primarily, but what we're going to start to discuss is the basic, the fall of the rupee, if you will, the fact that it has dropped to its lowest, at least to my, in my memory, that it has never come this low. So Paranjoy, why do you think the, shall we say, the secular decline of the rupee is taking place over the last few months?
Okay. Prabir, earlier in the morning of Thursday, the 28th of June, it became a historic date because the rupee has collapsed to its all-time low. In early trade, it came down by about 49 paise and to 69.10 rupees to a US dollar. So this is the historic low. Why is this linked to oil? Because I think there are a variety of reasons why the rupee has collapsed to its all-time low. But I would say among the most important reasons is the huge concerns about oil prices within the country and outside the country. Let's first look at what's happening in the international scenario. America has told its everybody, including India, not to buy oil from Iran, starting, I think, the 4th of November. Now, in addition to that, there have been some disruption in supplies from Libya and Canada. Now, India, as you know, is the world's third largest importer of oil. We are importing about 80% of our total requirements, and much of it is coming from Iran. Also from Iraq, also from Saudi Arabia. The proximity of Iran to India, all of these are factors which makes India import oil from Iran. Now, all of the, I mean, so the concerns within India that now oil prices are going to go up and that would widen the current account deficit. Already, by the way, the current account deficit, when you look at it where it is at present, about 160 billion US dollars, is more than 40% higher than what it was a year ago. Now you have various other factors, including the withdrawal of their investments by foreign portfolio investors, and you have a situation.
Well, that's an important point also to register. While we have rising oil prices, which means our import bill is going up, one of the additional elements this time is the fact that the Fed has increased its interest rate, which means there is also withdrawal of money from different places, including in India, and investing in the US. Oil prices, and Paranjoy has flagged it as one of the more important elements in the, shall we say, the weakening of the rupee. Do you see, for instance, the oil prices continue to grow up, or do you think with the decision of the OPEC to increase oil production that the prices may actually ease?
No, I don't think the decision to increase is in any manner going to reduce the prices. Because as I observed earlier, you see, very few members of the OPEC have the capacity to increase the production. Because any increase or decrease has to be shared by all. And there are not many who can do that except perhaps Saudi Arabia and United Arab Emirates. Venezuela is in no way to do that. Therefore, some analysts have calculated this so-called 1 million increase actually translates to a mere 460,000 barrels, which is less than half a million in the market. That is why if you noticed, as soon as the decision came, markets actually went up because there is a sentiment. They saw that there is a decision here, but that didn't mean anything actually. Because, you know, half a million tons of oil into the market, half a million barrels is not going to make any difference. And you see the calculations of the most of the OPEC countries, especially Saudi Arabia, which wants to hold it around 75 to 80, number of good reasons. And in fact, you know, they have all to balance their budgets. That is very important for them because their only source of revenue is oil. So too is Russia. Russia's budget balance is only at $100. Now they are also cooperating for good reasons. So this is a very important factor. And secondly, you know, the earlier gamble by Saudi Arabia to defeat the shale production by pulling down the gas oil price did not work, because you know the shale people, they are very aggressive cost cutting and remarkable developments in technology. Now therefore, you know, this $50, $40 is not going to curb shale production in any manner. So that they won't do. The only threat there for them is renewables. If these oil prices are held continuously for long, renewables below 70 may become viable, in which case they will start eating into the oil demand. I think this is a factor which they will consider it a little lower. Their immediate priority has been to see how to address the issue arising out of the US withdrawal from the Iran agreement.
So, in fact, the renewable part would be a longer term scenario, not a short term scenario. Short term, two issues really. One is withdrawal from Iran, as you said, the agreement to withdraw is only one part. The sanctions on all countries who would buy Iranian oil and gas is really the bigger issue. And the big stick the US wields by virtue of its control over the dollar. That is one. And the second, the biggest reserve holder in the world today, Venezuela, is also under sanctions. So these are the two things which make it difficult, according to you, for the oil, essentially the oil market, to ease.
Yes, and say, if I may just add to the question that Prabhu raised, when you say short and long, I mean, because it's going to have a direct impact on the value of the rupee, India's current account deficit, and inflation, above all, inflation at home because of diesel prices, petrol prices. How long do you expect these oil prices to be high, and when could they possibly ease? You know, I mean, if I ask you to predict the near
crystal ball gaze.
No, the most hazardous thing for anybody to do is to predict oil prices. In fact, that is a no-no. But anyway, you know, people factor in some things and see how the oil prices are going to behave. For all the reasons which you have mentioned, there is no good reason immediately for oil prices to come down. But there are plans. There were some plans done, you know, at the time of when the expectations were there about the Iran accord being signed with the previous administration. And some people felt that the agreement may not be signed. What to do at that time?
You're talking about the U.S. and
U.S.-Iran agreement.
Obama
administration. See, there were plans afoot at that time, for example, to take the Iran oil. For example, Russia was prepared to take the Iran oil as theirs and put in the market as their oil. And now there is a new development which has gone unnoticed, but which has got a lot of potential. China has started an exchange. Normally, you know, it is the sellers, big sellers, who have an exchange. But China, as the largest buyer, has started. The whole purpose is, you know, long back, you must have heard the concept of de-dollarization of oil. It is Iraq, you know, Saddam Hussein, who started and paid the price for it. Now, if the Chinese exchange mechanism succeeds, and the buyers and others, Europeans, etc.
And even the multilateral agencies like IMF and World Bank recognize yuan as a...
Yuan or any non-dollar currency. Yeah. It has a huge impact on the market at that time, both on prices and everything, on the efficacy of US sanctions. This is being watched very closely. You know, China doesn't, you know, begin things just like that without proper study.
I think that's a very important point you're making, that this in fact may lead to a situation where dollar is not the only reserve currency for oil. And till now, all the oil clearances, the market clearances, takes place through the dollar. And therefore, the US can actually sanction any country buying Venezuelan or Iranian oil. And while Venezuela may not affect us directly, Iran oil, as we all know, do. So in fact, this may lead to a situation where dollar does not become the only or the sole current, shall we say, currency of resort, last resort for every country in the world. That it could be the yuan becomes also a currency which people could use. But something to see. Paranjoy, last question to you. On the that when we had happy times, meaning oil price was falling, we had low inflation as a consequence, we had a fairly flexible budget because we didn't really lower the oil price, but we certainly took it in some form into the government exchequer through taxes. All of this, we didn't really plan for hard times.
You know, it's very important that you say this, and I'll take one step back. In the run-up to the 2014 elections, in fact, right through the second half of 2013, Mr. Narendra Modi, who was then just the prime ministerial candidate of the Bharatiya Janata Party, he had put out a series of devastating tweets. And I'll just give you a few examples. Who will fall lower, the Congress or the rupee? Question mark. In 1947, or when India became independent, 1 rupee equaled $1. Where are we now? Then he said that the rupee is in the ICU. He went on to say, he raised a question for the Congress party. Are you going to save your government or the rupee? Now, it's interesting that all this is now coming home to him. As you rightly pointed out, soon after Mr. Modi became the Prime Minister of India, oil prices were still high. They were about $115 a barrel. It came crashing down by January to, at one stage, about $20, $25 a barrel. Thereafter, it's been steady, but benign. But it's only recently, in the last 6 or 8 months, it's been firming and currently hovering in the $75 to $80, which has resulted in inflation going up. You know, before the Karnataka election, the Indian Oil Corporation didn't increase oil prices for 19 days, and suddenly after the elections, they went up. So all of which shows that we have less than a year to go for the next general elections. And once again, as in 2014, this is likely the value of the rupee, oil prices and inflation are going to become major political issues.
Thank you very much, Mr. Rao, Paranjoy, for being with us and having this discussion. This is all the time we have for NewsClick. Keep watching NewsClick and also visit our YouTube channel.